Good afternoon, everybody. Today we discuss alkaline cell. Okay. Previous we study lead cell. Today we discuss alkaline cell. Okay. Today we discuss of alkaline cell. It has a nickel plate rectangular container. Okay. This is a rectangular container. This is container used as a rectangular container. Okay. This container is coated with a thick layer of varnish to avoid short circuit in cell and is filled with 20% of caustic potassium. Okay, caustic potassium uses a coated of thick layer of varnish. Okay, to avoid of short circuit. Okay, along with some titanium hydroxide mix. Okay, some use of titanium hydroxide in it. This solution does the work of the electrolyte and its specific gravity is 1.17. Specific gravity is 1.17. okay, the positive plate consists of perforated nickel steel cylindrical tube filled initially with alternate layers of nickel hydroxide and metallic nickel in thin flux. Okay, a number of such tubes are mounted vertically. Okay, mounted of vertically in a container. Okay, the length of each tube is 12 centimeter length and 0.5 centimeter its diameter. Okay, the negative plate consists of perforated nickel steel. Pockets fill initially with iron oxide and a trace of mercuric oxide. Okay, trace of mercuric oxide. Okay, to improve its conductivity. This uses the improve of conductivity. Okay, improve for use as a iron oxide and a trace of mercuric oxide used to improve of conductivity. Okay, the length of its tube 7.5 centimeter and width is 1.2 centimeter and the thickness is 0.3 centimeter. Okay, all the positive plates are welded together with one terminal and negative plates with other terminal known as negative terminal. Okay, the number of negative plates is one more than that of the positive plate. Okay, one negative plate is more than that one positive plate because this use increase efficiency of the battery. Okay, below chemical reaction, the flowing reaction takes place during charge and discharge period condition. Okay, below chemical reaction, the following reaction takes place during charge and discharge period. Okay, during charging, during discharging, total combination of reaction. Okay, total combination of reaction, charging, discharging period and total combination reaction, total total combination of reaction. Okay, this process flow that. Okay, it can be seen from the equation that there is no difference while charging or discharging. Okay, the current in the electrolyte of the cell, when the cell is full charge, the EMF becomes 1.35 volts. Okay, and during discharge the EMF remain at 0.9 volt. Okay, discharge condition 0.9 volt and charge condition 1.35 volts per cell. Okay, the specific gravity of the electrolyte is 1.2. okay, 1.2 nu, but when it drop to about 1.16 volt, drop about 1.16 volt. Okay, after a number of years of service, new electrolyte must be poured into the cell. Okay, poured into the cell. Okay, the important characteristics of this cell is that if this cell is charged more, or if it is discharged, or if it is not frequently used. Okay, it does not get deteriorated. Okay, to protect it from the atmospheric effect, if its valves are airtight. Okay, which are open only at the time of charging. Okay, open only at the charging. Okay, advantage of alkaline cell. Number one, there is no bulking of plates. Okay, number two, there are no corrosion losses. Okay, number three, it may be overcharged or over discharge possible. Okay, number four, it is very robust and shock proof. Okay, number five, lighter in weight and thus it is portable. Okay, number six, it may remain in a discharge period for a long time. Okay, disadvantage of alkaline cell. Okay, number one, its efficiency is lower than that. Okay, of lead acid cell. Okay, number two, it has high internal resistance. Okay, number three, its EMF is low. EMF means to electromotive force. Number five, it is costly. Okay, as compared to lead acid cell, alkaline cell costly as compared to lead acid cell. Okay, lead acid cell. Look at this alkaline cell figure. Okay, this is a material tape or positive terminal insulation. Okay, this is a cell, carbon rod for electrolyte, zinc can electrolyte, porous separator, paste of magnesium oxide MnO2 and H4Cl, zinc chloride, water cathode. Okay, and metallic bottom as a negative terminal. Okay, positive terminal and negative, this is a alkaline. This is a alkaline cell. Alkaline cell. Okay, thanks everyone watching this video for